Another recent request that I got was to make a Scoodie. Well, I wasn't really positive on what a Scoodie was. And when I searched online, I found out it's nothing more than a hood with a scarf attached to it. Now, you could take my other hood that I did minus the collar on it and add the scarf, as I will show later. This time, I'm going to do a shaped hood. I was thinking of doing the front of the hood in rib with the ribber, but I decided not to because the ribber always gets in the way when I'm trying to record things. So if you have a ribber on, you could of course change that to rib of your choice, and then the rest of it's going to be the same. But here on the knitter only, I started off with waist yarn, a row of ravel cord. I am set on tension dial 3. Probably should have my mid-gauge out instead of the bulky. And the pattern has me start out with 114 stitches. This machine only has 110. So what I'll do is when it comes to the decreasing, I will decrease down to the 88 stitches. I think it is, yeah. And instead of knitting 6 rows, I'll end up with probably 10 rows, but I will work to the total 36 rows. So you can take this pattern because I'm missing 4 stitches, no big deal. Okay, so now for the double folded hem, what I'm going to do is something that some people have seen. I could do this all at tension dial 2, where the main body is worked at 3, but I want to work this down, not really decreasing, but I'm making the stitch side smaller. I have 12 rows to work with, and I do need to go down from 3 to 2. Because there's 3 dots between, or 2 dots between each number, I'm going to knit 4 rows, and then turn my tension dial down 1 click. So now I'm at 2 and 2 dots. I'm going to knit 4 more rows. Actually, I guess it should have been 3 rows because 4 more rows is going to put me at 12. Well, I think what I'll do is I'll do 16 rows just to make this right, but if you wanted to do the 12 rows, you're going to knit 3 rows, turn your tension dial down, knit 3 rows. And this just goes to show you that you could change part of a pattern. Even though it tells you to do one thing, you could do a different thing. Now here, I could take my garter bar and turn this all around, but I found when using the garter bar for the whole bed, it's a little bit harder to do. So something else you could do is just put your tension dial up, and I'm going to go up to 7, knit 1 row. I'm going to go back, that's actually the turning row. I'm going to go back down to tension dial 2, knit 4 rows, just so I don't confuse myself, I put this back to 16, or I could even put it to 0. Knit 4 rows. Put my tension dial up one click, knit 4 rows. Put it up one click, 4 more rows. One more click, which brings me back to tension dial 3, 4 rows. So now, okay, the carriage is over at the left, no big deal. I am going to remove my weights and the cast-on comb, and then I am going to hang my first row of the white yarn here onto the needles. I forgot one weight here. So here I go. Now, a lot of you don't realize it, but the yarn tail is actually a stitch. But that's all right. We don't have to have 2 stitches on each needle. So I'm going to take my 3-prong transfer tool and take the first 3 stitches above the ravel cord and then hang it on the needles. And then go into the next 3 stitches. Now, if this is a little tough for you, use your 2-prong tool. Of course, you could use your 1-prong tool. And just do that all the way down. So I have 2 stitches on every needle, except for the second from the end. The last one I put on the end here, I could have put it on the next to the last one, didn't really matter. Now I'm going to knit 1 more row to close off the folded hem. Next, the pattern tells me to work up 5 rows. I could count this last row as row 1. It doesn't really matter. That one extra row is not going to matter. But where I did do an extra 4 rows for the folded hem, I am going to count that one. Now I'm going to start decreasing, and I'm going to decrease 1 stitch at the end of this row, then every second row 12 more times. That's where I'll have the 88 stitches, and then work to row 36. So what I do is I like to take the 2 or 3 end stitches off the needle and move them 1 in. Of course, I got to do it on both sides. If you want to use just your 1-prong tool to move it in, you could do that. But when it comes to sewing, I like to have a straight stitch going up on the edge here so that I don't have 2 stitches on the end on that decrease when I'm sewing it. So actually, I had to put that to 5. So I take the 3 end needles, I take the stitches off of those, and I move them 1 inward, so I'm doing a decrease. Now the 3rd needle in has the 2 stitches. And actually, I should probably get a claw weight on the ends. This machine, you really only need those, but I like having the cast-on comb. Knit 2 rows, decrease, do that to 88 stitches remain. And then knit to row 36. I was paying more attention to the rows than I were to the needles, and as you see, I ended up with 80 stitches, 40 on each side, instead of the other four. But that's all right, because now I need to bind off so many stitches. It tells me 33 stitches on both sides, or the next two rows, but I have 22 stitches remaining. So what I do is, from left 13 all the way over, is I'm going to bind off these stitches, knit across, and then bind off the other stitches. And of course, you know I like doing the gate peg bind off most of the time on these machines. You can use the needle bind off. You could do the back stitch bind off if you want. It's really up to you. If I was to do the latch tool bind off, which is really my favorite, I would have to put the other needles into hold, knit these stitches at a higher tension dial, like 7 or even 10, latch tool bind off, knit across the rest of the row at tension dial 3, do the same on the other side. That's just a little bit more work. It's up to you. But you're going to take and you put the yarn to the left of the gate peg, you put your latch tool in the hook, pull it through, grab the yarn with your latch tool, pull it through that needle. Now I have to be careful because I'm not left-handed. So I go into the next hook, and actually it kind of took that stitch off of my latch tool and put it on the needle. But as you see, I go to the right of the needle and then pull it through there. I could give it a little tug now so that it tightens up the stitch that I'm binding off with. And of course, if you want to use your needles, you keep one needle. Let me see if I could do it from the right to the left in this case. Put my latch tool on the next needle, pull that through, grab the yarn, pull it through those two needles, put that empty needle back, have the yarn over the hooks here. I go to the next needle with the stitch on it, put the latch tool on the hook, pull it through, and then take the yarn and pull it through both those loops. But you need to bring that empty needle out. In order to do that. Then when you're done, with the gate peg bind off, you're just going to pull them off the gate pegs. For the ones with the needles, you're just going to pull the needles back. So again, I'm going to bind off these. Well, it wasn't 33, 29 stitches, I guess it is. Knit across the rest of the row, bind off the other side, 29 stitches, and then I'm going to work on the back part of the hood. Now, after you have the work off the machine, you're going to have to sew the bound off edges here to the side of the back. I already did one side there. And you just fold it with right sides together. And I do a run-in stitch, which turns out to be a mattress stitch. But now you have stitches going, they're not going the same as each other. But I take that little hair clip and I put it in place. And I did find that on the bound off edge with the gate pegs, I would go into that one stitch, and then on the side here, I would skip a row. So I would go every two rows to sew that up so that it does even out. So I go into the first stitch, on both sides here. Now I'm going to leave a long tail so I could weave that in over here. Then what I do is I look and I see the top stitch of the gate peg bind off. I see where the yarn's coming out of there. I skip one, I go into the next one. I move this up as needed, or I should put more than one on. So here, I'm right there, I skip one, I go into the next one. There's the last one I went into, there's the next stitch there. Go into the next stitch on the side there, skip a row, go into the next row. So as I get down to the end here, it evens out. And then you're going to weave in those yarn tails, and next we'll get to the scarf.